Ladies and gentlemen, I know you've been waiting a while for this one. Welcome back to the channel, fellas, and this is the first race of the Fiasco Short Track Combine, live from Dover International Speedway.
Hold on.
Now, I already know what you guys are probably gonna say. You're probably gonna go back to the trailer, and you're going to see that the first race is supposed to be at Kalamazoo. And then you're gonna go to your little keyboards and hop down to the comments section and say,
"Yo, Fiasco, the first race is supposed to be at Kalamazoo. What are you doing? You're already breaking your own rules."
Listen, shut up. Listen. There's a reason why we're not doing the race at Kalamazoo. Because every time the race would go under caution at Kalamazoo, this would happen. Okay, so are we understanding as to why we're not at Kalamazoo right now? We're good? You and me, we're good? Alright, just checking. So if you guys, I'd just like to throw this in real quick. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe. If you haven't liked the video already, drop a like. A lot of this stuff is coming out. And I hope you guys enjoy the first race of the Fiasco Short Track Combine. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, you heard that right. This is a combine full of prospects looking to get drafted into the Fiasco Racing Series that will be held in the near future after these 8 races are over. We will go from Dover all the way over to Phoenix. Then we'll hit South Boston, Richmond, Bristol, Rockingham, the Taylor Swift Superdome, and North Wilkesboro. Now let's take a look at the starting lineup for today's race. On pole is Alex Nieto and Carlos Borges in the front row. Michael Eschman and Cameron Barrero are in row 2. Row 3, Fred Berger and Mark Silas. Row number 4 is going to have Bob Ross and Jimmy Johnson. Row 5, Rusty Walrus, ironically in the 11, next to Li Zhang. Row 6, Ernesto Julio Rivera Gonzalez, next to Adi Borges. Row 7, Brendan Paunetto and Jason Sambon. Row 8 has Sean Riguez and Ryan Labonte. Row 9 has Eric Lopez and Ryan's younger brother, Ray. Row 10, Chris J and Christian Torres round out row 10. Row 11, Ricky Jackman Jr. and John. And row 12 rounding out the field is Eric Keplinger and Jade Pagan in the number 7. Hope you guys are ready for the start of the short track combine. 24 drivers are going to try to get drafted by the 8 teams that will be running in the Fiasco Racing Series in the near future. 16 drivers will get drafted, 8 drivers will go undrafted. Who is going to make a name for themselves in a short track combine? Green flag is out in the air, and the number 4 car of Carlos Borges is actually going to hit the line first before the leader, Alex Nieto, does. No penalties. We don't care about that round here. It doesn't even seem to matter as the number 3 on the backstretch has decided to take the lead from the number 4 of Carlos Borges. Hopping into turn 3, Michael Eschman takes a little peek at the number 3, but he's not going to be able to get the move done. Charges in a bit too hard, he's going to slide up in the middles of 3 and 4. Simply will hit the wall, and it looks like there's going to wreck in the backstretch. Brandon Paunetto in the number 22 goes around, and I think that collected a few more drivers we're going to have to check out on the replay here. And on the replay, it appears the 6 and the 15 got together. Adi Borges in the 15 came down and hooked the 22 of Brandon Paunetto, which also made contact with the number 2 of Sean Riguez. It looks like everybody else got through nice and clean. We're going to hop on board with Sean Riguez. It looks like he had nowhere to go. He tried to slide through to the bottom, and he was barely able to get out of the number 22's way. And he's going to be able to cruise on out for the rest of this race. Lap 6 coming onto lap 7, we're going to get the green flag back in the air. Carlos Borges was in the lead, and he's going to take us to the green flag. We are racing once more. There's only 20 laps here. All these races in the short track combine are going to be fairly short. These guys are definitely want to work up their stats, try to build up the best resume they can possible for those teams that are drafting in the Fiasco Racing Series. And it looks like we have a three-way battle for second place as Alex Nieto is going to slide up the track a little bit. Michael Eschman is going to make the move for second place. Textbook pass right there at quarter exit. You know, the scouts are definitely going to take notice of that as a massive wreck has taken place on the front stretch here at Dover International Speedway. We have no idea which drivers were those. And it looks like it is a 19 and the number 11 of Rusty Walrus barrel rolling down the front straightaway. A nasty, nasty wreck here on lap 8. And he also gets hit by Brandon Brandon Pondetto, who gets collected in another wreck. Who is at number 19? It is Ernesto Julio Rivera Gonzalez. He smashes that inside safer barrier and it explodes his engine, and then he loses control, hits it again, and he slides up the 24. Ricky Jackman Jr. gets involved, as does the number 9 of Eric Lopez and the number 10. They had absolutely nowhere to go. We're going to hop on board with Ricky Jackman Jr. Just nowhere to go. You cannot predict that sort of movement from the 19 on the bottom of the track there. Christian Torres and the number 10 taking a hard look as well. And look at Jade Pagan pulling out some Tokyo Drift type shit. Barely getting past the car on the bottom there. Rusty Wallers barrel rolling and Jade Pagan pulling off some Tokyo Drift nastiness to get by that wreck. You see it goes by Eric Lopez there. You know, the scouts are definitely going to take notice of people who can avoid wrecks. I have a feeling that the FRS is going to be full of nasty wrecks just like this, so it's definitely going to pay dividends if you have a driver that can avoid those kinds of wrecks. Lap 12, we're still under caution. We're going to get the green flag as we cross the line for lap 13. Carlos Borges in the number 4 is going to try to hold up the 3, 18, 17, and 12 as the green flag comes back out in the air. Not too much longer left in this race, only 8 laps to go. Can he hold on to the lead? Or will another caution come out soon and maybe he won't be able to have to hold on to the lead that much longer? It could be smooth sailing from here on out for the number 4. Alex Nieto is really on his back bumper right there, going into turn 3, trying to make a peak, trying to make this move, trying to get into the lead, but he's not going to be able to do it. The number 4 puts a little bit more distance between him and second place. Somebody's scraping the wall back there on the front straightaway, but it looks like everybody's good for once under green. Michael Esperin shoving the 3 up the track, trying to make that move just like he did earlier in this race. You see there's 3 wide back there for third place. Absolutely crazy racing, the 17, the 16, and the 12. A 3-way battle for fourth place. Top 5s do matter a lot in here. You really want to get a good average finish. Here in the Fiasco Short Track Combine, we're not keeping track of points. There's going to be no champion. Everybody is just trying to get the best possible statistics they can. Crossing the line for lap 16. It looks like somebody way back there on the front straightaway loses control. It looks like the 13 of Ryan Labonte, but he manages to keep it together. That is going to look good on the record book for the scouts. Somebody who can keep the car on track, somebody who can stay composed and then hold on to the car like that, that takes a lot of car control, and that is going to look very good, not on the stats, but on his attributes for when the scouts are really looking for a solid driver to drive their car. As we have crossed the line for the final lap here at Dover International Speedway, it looks like Carlos Borges is leading by half a second over Alex Nieto in the number 3. There's not going to be much of a fight for first place, but there is a battle for second, and it looks like that battle for second is going to dwindle down as well. Coming out of turn 4, Carlos Borges in the number 4 is going to get the first win at the Fiasco Short Track Combine. That is going to look great on his scouting report for when the draft comes up in a few weeks. And I can tell he's very excited to have gotten that win. That is certainly going to increase his draft stock. Dover Combine Top 10. Here we have Carlos Borges, Alex Nieto, Mike Eshman, Bob Ross, Mark Silas, Jason Sambon, Adi Borges, Chris J, Jimmy Johnson, and Fred Fredberger rounding out the Top 10 here at Dover. Looking great on their scouting reports so far, but will they be able to keep it up when we go to Phoenix next week? Final results, 11th through 20th, Sean Riguez, John, Lee Zhang, Eric Kettlinger, Jade Pagan, Ray Labonte, Brother Ryan Labonte, Brendan Pondetto, Eric Lopez, and Ernesto Julio Rivera Gonzalez rounding out the top 20 in today's race. Not looking too hot under draft stock, but they have definitely time to improve that. The bottom 4, unfortunately, it is the 11 of Rusty Walrus, Ricky Jackman Jr., Christian Torres, and Cameron Barrero. If you guys did enjoy, again, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. See ya. Clean, and I've been going, no distractions. Drive music like it's rations. I take it past the average. My fans, they gotta have it, yeah. I make tracks for all the kids with no purpose. I let them know that they're worth it, that all the feelings.